When you sit down to a holiday meal, one of the questions you might be asked is white or dark meat. No matter what your preference is, one of the things you might not have considered is why are there two types of meat at all? We're burrowing deep into your holiday dinner to find the science of muscles. Meat is the muscles of an animal, and we generally cook our meat before eating it, which changes the color and chemistry of the meat. But the meat starts out a little different in a living animal. Muscles have different jobs in the body. For a long-distance runner, the muscles in their legs need to be slow and steady, providing a consistent amount of power for a long time. These muscles all require oxygen in their production of energy. Oxygen is pulled into the muscle by a molecule called myoglobin. The more oxygen the muscle needs to pull in, the more myoglobin it will have. And hey, myoglobin is red. If you've ever heard the term red meat, this is what it's talking about. So if you are looking at red meat, it's coming from a part of an animal which needs lots of endurance. Animals that walk around. Animals that swim long distances. The opposite type of muscle is one which only operates for short bursts. They power themselves with carbohydrates, breaking them into lactic acid as fast as possible, no oxygen required. This lets a turkey, say, fly up into a tree really fast to get away from a predator. The turkey doesn't fly long distances, but it has the option of bursting into short flights when needed. Or another example is fish that lurk at the bottom of the sea, then burst up to catch food. These muscles do not have as much myoglobin, so they are kind of see-through in a living animal. There is a possibility that muscle type is not fixed, but can change with use. So a hypothetical turkey that flew often would develop more myoglobin in its flight muscles. I'm curious to see where this field of study goes. Anyway, back to dinner. Cooking makes the proteins change. As soon as meat reaches 140 degrees Fahrenheit, the myoglobin and other proteins start to change. Myoglobin turns into a series of compounds that are browny-grey in color, and the translucent fast-twitch muscles turn opaque and white.
And that's where dark and white meat come from. Now you can tell your friends and family about the science on their plates. Dark meat is for endurance, white meat is for bursts of speed, and all the meat is a meal shared with those special to us. Unless you're a vegetarian, in which case you might still enjoy telling people about the science on their plates. If you would like to spend more time learning about birds, please subscribe to this channel and check out these other interesting videos. Thanks for stopping by this week to learn what makes life awesome.